everyone. Welcome to Smart Learning Academy. Myself, Madhushree Datta, and I'm educator of SLA. Since you all know that we run the free crash courses on various life science exams, we have just not stopped on it. We are bringing the molecular tools and the technique lessons absolutely free of cost on our YouTube platform. And to your information, we are also starting the GATE crash courses that would be taken by me and the other top educators. So if you're preparing for GATE, do join us and make your dreams come into reality, as Sir says.
Welcome to Smart Learning Academy. Today we'll be starting with the first lesson of the molecular diagnostic technique. The lesson would be on the PCR basic. So before going further into the detail, let me tell you something about myself. I have been a rank holder in BSc in Botany, MSc in Botany with a specialization in the plant physiology, biochemistry and molecular biology. I have been recruited as a research fellow in CSIR IHBT based in Palampur. I have been a former project fellow in the Banaras Hindu University. These are the few national exams that I tend to qualify. So since we were talking about the molecular diagnostic tools, so the molecular diagnostic tool is basically divided into three broader categories: amplification, blotting and hybridization. Today we would be talking about the amplification techniques, to be precise, on the PCR. So PCR is what? So what is PCR basically? So PCR is a polymerase chain reaction. It is an in vitro or the cell-free cloning. So that means it is not dependent upon the host cell. It was developed by Carey Mullis. It involves selective amplification of a specific target DNA sequence within a total genomic DNA. Prior information of the target DNA sequence is required to design the primers complementary to the template. So what is PCR basically? It involves a selective amplification of a specific target DNA sequence for which we need to design the primers, and for designing such primers we need the prior information of the target DNA sequence. So I think these two points must be clear to you. Now let's move to the fifth point. The primers are added to the 3' end of the DNA template, so the polymerizing enzymes can synthesize the copies using 3' end of the Brown primer. So what does that mean? It means if a template is running from 5' to 3' directions, the primer would be added to its 3', and this 3' hydroxyl group of the bound primer would be free, so the polymerizing enzyme and the other essential components of the PCR can carry out the further amplification process. So what are the essential components of the PCR? The essential component of the PCR is basically the template DNA, which can be the double-stranded DNA or the cDNA, that is complementary DNA, the primers, which are also known as amplimers, the dNTPs, which are the DNA precursors, the thermostable DNA polymerase. So basically, what is thermostable DNA polymerase? So as we go further into the detail, we'll see that the PCR has been divided into the three reactions that have been carried wise in a stepwise manner. And first reaction of such would be denaturing or denaturation. That is basically is being carried out at a higher temperature. And to withstand such temperature, we need the thermostable DNA polymerase. So what more we need? We need the buffer and the divalent cations. So since we were talking about the reaction cycle of the PCR and its steps, so as I was saying, it is being divided into three broader categories, that is the denaturation, primer annealing, and the extension. So what is basically the denaturation step is doing? So denaturation step is being carried out at a higher temperature, around 95 degrees Celsius, which would cause the hydrogen bonds to break and separate. So where is this hydrogen bonds is being found? Between the bases in two stands. Now let's move to the second step, that's primer annealing. So primer annealing is being carried out at a temperature that would be lower than that of the denaturing temperature, but would be higher as compared to so the primer annealing is basically carried out at a low temperature with respect to the denaturing condition, but it should not be much lower, because if it is lower, it will form the mismatched hybrids. So the next step is the extension. So the extension step is being carried out by the tagged DNA polymerases. So what's this? Basically, the tagged DNA polymerase is doing, it attaches to the primer and then adds the DNA bases to the single stranded DNA in 5' to 3' directions. This is a pictorial representation of the stages, which is a denaturing stage, annealing stage, and the extensive stage. And this is the respective temperatures on which it is being carried out. So there are a few things that you should keep in mind while designing the primer. So what are those few things? It's their primer length, the nature of sequences, the base composition, and the TM value. So the primer length should be around 15 to 25 base pair. And what kind of sequences do you need? The inverted sequences or the self-complementary sequences should not be greater than 3 base pair, because if it is greater than 3 base pair, it will form the hairpin loop and would prevent the primer annealing. And what is the second kind of sequences that we need? There should not be any complementary between the sets of primers used. Now let's drop to the third point. What does it say? That the base composition of G plus C should be greater than 60%. So now let's drop to the TM value. So what is basically the TM value? TM value is basically the temperature at which the half of the DNA strand is in double stranded state. So this TM value is being calculated by a rule known as Wallace rule, which is being depicted as TM equals to 4 into G plus C plus 2 into A plus T. Now let's see what are the list of thermostable DNA polymerases. So here is a list that is TAC, TA, TILI, VENT and PBO. So this TAC is having no hexonuclease activity from 3' to 5' directions, whereas TILI, VENT and PBO is having the hexonuclease activity, that is a proofreading activity, from 3' to 5' directions. So now let's drop into the calculation of the PCR product. So the calculation of the PCR product is being done by the two major formulas, that is NF equals to NI into 2 to the power N. So what is NF? It is the final number of the DNA molecules produced by the PCR, and NI is the initial number of molecules used as a template, and N is the number of cycles performed. And the second most important formula is the PCR product is equal to initial input amount into 1 plus percentage efficiency to the power N, that is the number of cycles performed. And always remember, these two formulas are very important with respect to any life science exam. So now let's conclude the lesson with our final slide, where we'll be discussing with the advantages and the applications of the PCR. So what are the advantages of the PCR? It's real-time monitoring, it should be fast, cost-effective, and it should have ability to detect the less common organisms such as viruses. And what are the applications? It can be used for the identification of the infection agents, for genetic fingerprinting, for detection of the mutations, and for the cloning genes and PCR sequencing. Sure, don't forget to like the video, share and subscribe, and do drop down a feedback. What video do you want us to make next?